Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the very important disease of horse, that is strangles. Starting with the introduction, the strangles is an infectious, contagious bacterial disease of Equidae family characterized by abscession of the lymphoid tissue of the upper respiratory tract. The presence of pus-filled lymph nodes and throat inflammation cause difficulty in breathing. Strangles is also known as equine distemper. The causative organism for strangles is Streptococcus equi. It is gram-positive, capsulated beta-hemolytic, lance-filled group C coccus, which is an obligate parasite and a primary pathogen for strangles. If we can see its epidemiology, the disease is distributed worldwide and the incubation period is 3 to 12 days and disease runs its course in 2 to 4 weeks. Transmission can take place direct horse-to-horse contact. It also spread by nasal discharge or material from the draining abscess, by contaminated bedding material as well as poor ventilation. The transmission indirectly carried out by contaminated pastures, barns, feed troughs, etc., and by vectors like fly. If we can see its pathogenesis, after the entry of Streptococcus equi into the host, it primarily attaches to the cells on the tonsillar crypts and the ventral surface of soft palate. Then the organism slowly multiplies into the lymph nodes and subsequent migration of neutrophils takes place into the lymph node, which causes swelling and abscession. Nasal shedding usually begins 4 to 7 days after the infection. The clinical signs observed are the fever, which is first sign of the infection, and mucoid to mucopurulent nasal discharge and depression is evident. There will be difficulty in swallowing, inspiratory respiratory noise, extended head and neck, pneumonia, purpura hemorrhagica, and heart disease are also seen. Retropharyngeal lymph node enlargement may cause obstruction of the oro and nasopharynx with subsequent dyspnea and dysphagia. Submandibular lymph adenopathy can be visible. Compression of the dorsal pharyngeal wall. Abscession in the other lymph nodes of the body, like it is also called as metastatic strangles or bastard strangles, abdomen and thorax and brain. Here you can see there is a swollen lymph node on the lower mandible side, and in the second picture you can easily see the abscess. For the diagnosis purpose, history can be well checked. Either it is cold weather, unhygienic condition, what is age of the animal, and stress condition of the animal. Second one, clinical signs, presence of nasal discharge, anorexia, fever, and depression. And on postmortem, abscess in internal organs like spleen, lungs, pleura, and peritoneum will showcase the presence of these strangles. Third one is the bacterial culture, in which you can easily identify the Streptococcus bacteria. PCR, endoscopic examination of the upper respiratory tract, ultrasonography and radiographic examination can also be done for the diagnosis. If we can see its treatment, normally warm compression, which is applied to the sites of lymph adenopathy to facilitate the maturation of abscess. Regular antiseptic dressing with povidone iodine solution on the affected sites. NSAIDs and antibacterial drug can be administered. The disease can be controlled through vaccination, in which there are two vaccines of strangles are available in the market. First one is a subunit M protein based vaccine. Second one is the modified live bacterial vaccine for intranasal administration. Vaccine provides protection for 6 months. The disease can also be controlled by isolation of newly arrived horse, sanitation and disinfection of the areas where the horses are kept. One should wear protective clothing or change clothes before traveling to the next equine facility, and quarantine for 14 to 21 days are advisable for the control of the disease. Thank you very much, and please do like, comment and subscribe on my channel.